most of you guys have a nightmare of the subject called maths, and some of you even consider this subject as useless. But today is the day where you all will be getting the importance of this useless subject in most of your favorite game, that is cricket. So let's begin. A very good day to all my respected teachers and my dear friends. Today, I, Shreyansh Gupta, along with my friend Sarthak, will be explaining you all the importance of maths in most popular sport of India, that is cricket. We have divided the video into 3 parts for your convenience, and each part will be covering one frequently thought question by most of us. So, let's begin the video. All of us, especially cricket lovers, must have noticed the speed of ball displayed on TV screens just after it has been bowled. Most of you might have wondered that how do they calculate the speed of ball such quick, as there is no instrument seen along the cricket pitch which could measure it. So, the simple answer of this question is the speed gun. It is present at one side of the ground. In a speed gun, a transmitter is present which releases microwaves, and a receiver is present which catches them back. And the frequency change between the release phase and the catch phase is operated with some formula, and finally we are able to get the speed of the ball. But here comes a disadvantage. The speed captured by the speed gun is the speed of ball at that instant where the bowler immediately throws the ball. But till the time it would reach the batsman, the speed will decrease due to the friction and the bounce. So, in order to find approximate average speed throughout the motion of the ball, we can simply use the formula average speed is equal to distance upon time, where distance will be the length of cricket pitch which can be seen over here, and time will be from the moment the bowler throws the ball till the moment either the batsman hits the ball or the ball goes behind the stumps. But this average speed is not shown on the TV screens, as it is the instantaneous one captured by the speed gun. Hope so from this part you get to know the mystery behind the calculation of bowling speed. Thank you.
I'm Sarthak Gupta, and today I'm going to explain you about the second most thought question in cricket, which includes the concept of mathematics. Most of us must have wondered about how the calculation of range is done within seconds and showed on our television screen. This question can be explained with a simple concept of projectile motion. When the batsman hits the ball at a certain angle, it follows a parabolic path. The displacement of the ball depends upon 3 factors, which are the angle of projection, that is theta, the velocity of projection, that is v, and the gravitational constant g. To calculate the displacement, we use a formula, that is displacement is equals to v square sine 2 theta by 2g. This tells us about the displacement between the point of projection and the point of contact of ball with the ground. Hope so from this part you get to know about the calculation of range of the ball's motion. Friends, have you wondered about how the cricket matches are telecasted with good quality all over the country? The device used to telecast matches with such good quality is known as Spidercam. It is fitted with high quality microphones and high quality cameras. This device weighs nearly about 30 to 40 kgs. To provide support to this device, it is hanged with 4 Kevlar wires which are very thin and very strong. This device is controlled with fiber optic cables which are present in the 4 Kevlar wires. This device has a very fast movement speed of 30 to 40 km per hour. Thus, with the help of Spidercam, we are able to capture weird angles with such good quality. Hope so from this part you are able to understand about the good quality telecast.
I really want to appreciate all my respected teachers and my friends for watching the video till the end. It was a small effort by us to generate your interest towards mathematics, and from now we hope that you all will enjoy this useful subject and change your perception towards it.